A better future for Southern Africa depends on trade facilitation and infrastructure.
Investment in rail.
One-stop border posts.
Better roads.
Connectivity, physical cohesion is what brings people together.
When we talk about the North-South Corridor, it affects everyone.
Everything has got to work as a whole, and you've got to move everybody at the same time, at the same pace.
We'll see our future, the future of our children, changing.
At Chirundu, we have a functioning one-stop border post, and basically the function of a one-stop border post is to simply reduce the transaction costs by reducing the time taken to cross the border.
We opened Chirundu on 4th December, and the two presidents of Zambia and Zimbabwe came and opened the commission, the border post.
We have definitely reduced the clearance time for our commercial cargo.
Before, we were just waiting maybe for 1 week, 2 weeks, but nowadays you can wait maybe one day. You come today, tomorrow you're going. This system they introduced now is best.
With reduced costs, then we can get more goods to market cheaper, and obviously the general public benefit from it.
We are actually working as a team, and as my brother.
Sumbalesa border, where we are, is the major entry point for goods going into the Congo. Because of the small road, which cannot allow more than two vehicles to crisscross, we have a shift in our structure. In the morning, Zambia allows traffic to come from the Congo into Zambia and beyond. In the afternoon, Zambia sends traffic into the Congo.
What we are planning to do is to improve the efficiency of those border posts by simplify and harmonize the procedures of the two countries.
We've just relocated to this, the current new border, which is giving us a lot of room to operate and effect. We will expand the road so that we can allow free flow of traffic into the Congo and out of the Congo, into Zambia and out of Zambia.
Trade within the SADC region, it will be able to move at a good rate. South Africa will appreciate what we are doing here because they will receive goods in good time.
You cross from Botswana into Zambia at Kazungula. The current crossing at Kazungula is a ferry.
Because the limiting factor at Kazungula right now is the use of pontoons across the Zambezi. There is no bridge. So most transporters shun that route.
Last week I was waiting on that border, on the Botswana side, for almost 9 days.
Kazungula, there has been some progress in terms of infrastructure development.
There are plans to construct a fixed road and rail bridge across that point.
Maybe towards the end of the year, we'll see dust coming out from the area. We expect construction to take about 4 years.
So when the bridge is done and we move in to do a one-stop border post, which we shall, then that will be very, very good for the North-South Corridor.
Very excited. We just can't wait. The waste should be done overnight.
Quite frankly, there are some type of goods which should never be on the roads because of the damage they may tend to cause. Those type of goods should have been on the railway, which is more efficient and also which would actually take up that type of loads.
Primary cause why this line was constructed is to transport the copper exports.
People are using the road because of lack of capacity. The demand for our services is higher than what we can provide. So we need a lot of capital injection.
it's a question of investments that needs to be put in expanding, in extending, and also just maintaining the railway network at a good operational standard.
The demand for transport is very high. So that gives me hope that should we improve our services, or should we get that assistance which we need, then the future is very bright.
Quality of our road network, it's not very good. So we need to invest into improvement of a road network so that we can be able to have an efficient transportation system in Laos.
Yani hapa kila siku gari zinadondoka hapa. Na leo kama utakuepo hapa itadondoka nyingine hapa. Kila siku. Njia mbaya.
Roads are a serious risk to our operations. We actually have to transport across quite a few dirt road areas. We normally send 4 or 5 truckloads every day. Well, for about a week, we actually couldn't get any concentrates out, and obviously we couldn't also get diesel in. We have heard that money has now been allocated to fix the road, and we're looking forward to that actually being done.
This year, we are upgrading or reconstructing most of the existing roads to higher standards. We want to have the best roads in this sub-Saharan Africa, and I know we shall make it as a region.
We need to weigh the trucks in order to make sure that they don't overload, because if we can just leave them truck use the road while they are overloaded, we think that the road cannot last, and they can even sometimes cause accidents on the road.
From 2004, we found that actually 25% of every commercial vehicle was found to be overloaded. We have now reduced it to less than 3% by axles.
Transporters complain that we've got too many way bridges along our transport corridors, so there's a need to rationalize the number and the location of the way bridges.
We want to minimize so that the travel time is reduced, you know, so that people will benefit. Together we are partners. Together we want to promote trade in the Southern Africa.
Our direction towards the future is to make sure that we are efficient. Efficiency is the key word.
Yes, we have achieved, but we need to do more. We need to work extra hard. We need to cooperate more, and we need those decisions.
You know, it's not an easy thing, but with determination, you'll get there.
We want efficiency on the corridors. Now, that efficiency on the corridors can only be achieved if all these regional economic communities are planning together and working together.
Even one country, if you are not connected, you can't be united.